हेलो चिल्ड्रेन, हाउ आर यू? आई होप ऑल ऑफ यू आर फिट एंड फाइन एंड एंजॉय योर हॉलीडेज। विद एंजॉय वी ऑल्सो फोकस ऑन आवर गोल एंड स्टडी। इन ऑर्डर टू दिस वी विल स्टार्ट आवर क्लास टूडे। टूडे वी विल डिस्कस द फर्स्ट चैप्टर ऑफ आवर बुक फूड, वेयर डज इट कम्स फ्रॉम। इन दिस वीडियो वी विल डिस्कस द फॉलोइंग टॉपिक्स:
variety of food, different sources of food, and food habits of animals. First, food. What is food? Every day we are eating something to fulfill or to satisfy our hunger. These things are called food. For example, we are eating kheer. Kheer is a food which is made by using rice, milk, sugar and dry fruits. So these all materials that we use in kheer is called ingredient of kheer. So we can define the food as a substances from which an organism derive energy and materials for its growth and maintenance. Ask your friend, what does he take in breakfast? Does it take in same as you? No, you will notice your friend eat different food items. It means there are a variety of food around us and it varies from place to place.
Food preferences vary from state to state and from one country to another. Even at the same place or in the same family, the food habits of the different people are different. Some are like chapati, but some are don't like it. Someone like rice, but the others don't like it. So we can say even in the family or at the same state or a same place, different people have the different food habits. They are eating differently.
Now, sources of food. Our foods are obtained from either plant or animals. So we can say there are two main sources of food, that are plant and animals.
If we talk about the food obtained from the plant, we can group these items or these food materials into seven main categories. The first one is cereals. Second, pulses, vegetable, fruits, beverages, spices, oil, and sugar. If we talk about the cereals, you can see the farmers are growing cereals like maize, wheat, and rice. So many cereals are grown around us which we use as a food. The second is the pulses. The different type of pulses are also grown in our outside or by our farmers. For example, arhar, masoor, moong, etc.
Now vegetable. You are eating potatoes, brinjal, cauliflower, carrot and ladyfinger. These all are the vegetables that we are using and getting it from plants. The next is the fruit. You have eaten apple, mangoes, bananas, orange. These are the fruits that we are obtained from the plants and using in our daily food habits. The next is the spices. Every day for cooking our food, we are using the different type of spices like turmeric, ginger, chili, cardamom, etc. The beverages that we are using in our daily life are teas and coffee. We also obtain the oil from the seeds of the different plant. For example, mustard seeds, sunflower seeds, groundnut seeds,
Soyabean seeds are used for getting the oil. Sugar that we are eating every day are obtained from the plants like sugar cane and beetroot or sugar beet.
Milk, meat and eggs that we are obtained from animals. So we can say the animals are also the source of food as they are providing us milk, meat and egg that we are using in our food. We obtain milk from cow and goat. We obtain egg from duck and hen. Meat from hen and goat. Next topic is feeding habits of animals. Different species of living organism have different eating habits. Some animals eat grass, whereas some animals eat the flesh of other animals, while some other animals eat both the plants and the flesh of other animals. So we can group the animals into the three category on the basis of their feeding habits. Three groups of animals on the basis of their eating habits are herbivores, carnivores and omnivores. The animals eating plants or plant products are called herbivores. Here you can see deer is eating grass and rabbit is eating carrot. So these two animals are called herbivores. The other example of herbivores are cow, buffalo, etc. Second group is carnivores. The animals which are eating flesh or meat of the other animals, are they completely depend on the flesh of other animals, are called carnivores. For example, lion, fox. The third group of animals are omnivores. The animals in this group eat both plant as well as animal product. For example, human being, crow. Now next question is, why do we need food? Can we live without food? The answer is no. We can't live without food. So what is the use of food in our daily life? We need food for the various purposes. We need food to get energy, to grow, to maintain good health and to fight against disease. So in lack of food, we will not get energy to do the work and our growth is also affected badly. So that is why the food is necessary part of our life and we have to eat healthy food every day. Now this is the time for assignment. I hope all of you understood these all topics and you can answer these questions very easily. So please write the answer in rough copy and inform me in the comment box. Four questions are here. First question, what is food? Second question, why do we need food? Third question, what are the main sources of food? And fourth question, classify the animals on the basis of their food habit. Thank you. Have a nice day.